I am still work in progress. These are just the tips that have helped me during this time. Tara, hey Ifam, welcome to the EJ Club. So today we're going to do this video this way on portrait mode. Yes, I am a photographer based in Nairobi, Kenya. So guys, today I want us to talk about street photography. Why street photography? Because 4 years ago, my Facebook just reminded me of my first ever street photography workshop that I did with Canon. I was still in school. I've been improving. I went and sat down and compared my work ever since. And I wanted to give you the tips on how to have a successful street photography in Nairobi, Kenya. So without any further ado, let's get into it. So, tip number one, I've written them here. So if you see me looking down, just know I'm getting my notes ready. Tip number one, I'll say know your camera gear. For example, if you are starting off and you haven't mastered your camera yet, I would advise you to do your homework. Do not skip the basics. Go on to YouTube, Google, know what works well in speed, know what works well when it's calm and nice, when there's too much sun, and know what you want to shoot. For your camera gear, don't go with very big zoom lenses. You'll make people panic in the streets. Remember, being a street photographer is like being a sniper, so you don't want to pull so much attention onto you. Know your speed. If you blink, you lose. So your settings is something that you really need to work on. Tip number two, know your locations. How familiar are you with your street? So I'm in Nairobi, Kenya. I go to the streets of Nairobi all the time. But while you're in the streets, that is your only time to do a recce. If you're in production, you know what I mean by recce. Know all the corners of your streets. I do not know all the corners, but I know where I can go and shoot. Know where there is safety. Being familiar with your streets, meaning you might be familiar with the people. Tip number three, shoot what moves you. Like, shoot what you like. For example, I love shooting people on zebra crossing. I don't know why, but even if I go to shoot with people, I just like to find zebra crossing. So if you like cats, if you like dogs, if you like buildings, it's, for example, you've seen what Mtu Amadeka is doing. I like how he's shooting buildings because he's an architect. So I think he loves buildings and he's really doing a good job. So shoot what moves you. Tip number four is find the unusual. Stop copying people. Stop doing what Emmaculate is doing. Stop doing what some photographer in New York is doing. Shoot, find that unusual thing that no one has done. I look up to so many photographers. I can only be me. So be you and find your unusual. As my mentor always says, every photographer has a different eye. So find your eye. Number five. This is the tip that I love. Screw them rules. Why should you even follow the rules? Photography means freedom. You are doing photography for you. Just shoot and put your work out there. I am still work in progress. These are just the tips that have helped me during this time. I'm still learning, I'm still, of course, researching, but screw them rules. Watakufanya nini? So go out there, shoot. If you're shooting this in this quarantine time, please be safe. Take all the precautions that you can and go shoot.